नमस्ते, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। सिंस लास्ट मेनी इयर्स आई हैव बीन रिसीविंग दिस पर्टिकुलर रिक्वेस्ट आफ्टर आई मेड अ वीडियो ऑन जगन्नाथपुरा। मेनी ऑफ माय स्टूडेंट्स एंड फॉलोअर्स हैव इंक्वायर्ड अबाउट द सेटिंग्स दैट आई यूज इन जगन्नाथपुरा। समटाइम्स बिकॉज दे आर नॉट एबल टू replicate the chart in the same way as I present it in the class or in my videos. And many times, because the predictions that I am able to make using my own settings, they are not able to make it using the default settings in Jagannathpura, the software which is given to the astrological world by PVR Narasimha Rao. We are ever thankful to him. Thank you, Narasimha ji, from my side for making this amazing, amazing software. Why I use it? Because this software, according to me, have the maximum customizations that I have seen. And because of this ability to customize, I use Jehora, Jagannathpura. In this particular video, I will take you through the settings, calculation-based settings that I use in my personal Jagannathpura. And I will also give you a small intro about why I use a particular setting. I wish to make this video in a series. So in the upcoming parts of this video, I will explain other settings that I use in Jehora, like the settings that I use in Dasha, etc. also. So let's get started with the video without wasting our time. This is Jagannathpura software, right? First thing first, to make a chart, you go to this data button, right? And you choose the month, date, and year of birth. Normally, the calendar uses Gregorian, right? Earlier times, Julian calendar was also used. It is only used for old dates, actually. Right now, Gregorian calendar is used only. Birth time, minutes, seconds is given here. You can use either AM or PM format or 0 to 24 hour formats, of course. Gender is sometimes needed for Jaimini Dashas. For an example, the school of Sriman Irangati Rangacharya, the thought of Sriman Irangati Rangacharya on Jaimini Dashas calculates Dashas differently for men and women. For an example, if you go to the Charadasha of Sriman Irangati Rangacharya. For females, it is used in a different method. And for male, it is calculated from a different method. Generally, for female, the starting of the Charadasha is from a different sign, and the starting of a Charadasha for a male chart is for a different sign. So if you are going to use the thought of Sriman Irangati Rangacharya for Jaimini astrology, it is very essential to choose the gender. At this place, you can choose the birth city of the person, of course. Right? The software is quite illustrative in this particular matter. And if the place belongs to USA, you can select any state in USA, or in other parts of the world, you can use just this drop-down menu to go there. Or you can just, you know, type, like if I have to choose India, I can just type I. So I will have all the options for all the countries that starts from I, and I can just go to one particular place. Now, here is something that I will want to specifically highlight for new learners. For an example, suppose I want someone is born in Bilaspur and I want to enter the details. Now, if you search for Bilaspur, there are many Bilaspurs in India. And one Bilaspur is in Himachal. That comes before Sundarnagar, one Bilaspur is in Chhattisgarh. See, you get multiple latitudes and longitudes for this. To tackle this problem, I have a very simple way. You open Google, search for Bilaspur. Now there is a Bilaspur in Chhattisgarh. There is a Bilaspur in Himachal Pradesh. You open the Wikipedia article, and right here on this on the screen, the top right hand side, you can see the coordinates, right? Bilaspur that comes in Himachal Pradesh, its coordinates is 31, 33 north, 76, 75 east. Whereas the Bilaspur that comes in Chhattisgarh, its latitude is 22, 09 north and 82, 15 east. So at those places where we have, so this is how, sorry, my screen was not shared. This is how I searched it on Google. So Bilaspur, Himachal Pradesh have coordinates of 31, 33 north and 76, 75 east. Whereas the Bilaspur of Chhattisgarh have 22, 09 north and 82, 15 east. Okay. Now I want to, suppose I want to select the Bilaspur of Himachal Pradesh as the birthplace. I will take this 31, 33 and 76, 75. And I will use that. Now you see, I will make it a bit complex. Now you see that I don't get this exact coordinate. Now you can see that I'm not getting this exact coordinate of 31, 33. Right? So in that scenario, I can also modify it. So 31 north 23 written there, I can write 31 north 33. And 76, 75 east, 76 written, I can add the minutes, I can also write 75, right? So with multiple options, you are, when there are multiple options for a particular place, you are left with two options. Either you choose the appropriate one from the all the latitudes and longitudes given in the software itself, consult Wikipedia for that. Or you can also write it manually and can select OK, and the planetary positions for that particular place will be written. After giving you an introduction of these basics, now let me proceed to my settings, right? These preferences, this is the place where you change your settings from preferences related to calculations, Siddhanta. There are two Siddhanta options available here. One is Drick Siddhanta and one is Sri Surya Siddhanta. Drick Siddhanta means, Drick means sight. Siddhanta means methodology for calculating a planet. Drick Siddhanta means the planetary positions as observed by modern planetariums. The planetary position as you see in the sky right now, Varahamihir and all the sages advocate planetary positions to be written as they are in the sky. So for normal purpose, Drick Siddhanta calculations will be used. According to some authors, traditional Indian authors generally, they advocate that the planets written in the horoscope are not the actual planets of the sky, but they are other planets. They are other heavenly bodies, which is written. Generally, this thought came because Surya Siddhanta, the text, owing to multiple interpolations, interpretations, and being old, the calculations of the text of Surya Siddhanta have now become obsolete. The traditional people who still follow Surya Siddhanta opine that the calculations given in Surya Siddhanta should be used. And that represents the real planets, whereas what we see in the sky are not the real planets. However, I am completely in opposition to this view. For an example, Varahamihir wrote Panchasiddhantika, where he compares the five methods of calculating the planetary positions. And he advocates Surya Siddhanta, saying that it is the most accurate for this time. Even if you go to Prashnamarga, Vishnu Nambudiri in Prashnamarga also talked about five types of Siddhanta. And once again, he advocates the uses of Surya Siddhanta with the logic that the calculations of Surya Siddhanta matches with the current planetary position in the sky to the maximum extent. To tell you, in earlier times, there were three types of texts. One was Siddhanta. In the Siddhanta text, how to calculate the planetary positions were written, and the current planetary states are also given. Suppose, for an example, Aryabhatta is a person. Aryabhatta is an astronomer. In earlier times, there was nothing such as NASA. People never had telescopes. And only the astrologer who was the king's personal astrologer had the access to planetary positions. He had access to observatories from where he was able to see planets. Suppose there is a person, Aryabhatta. He looks at the planetary positions for 30 years or 40 years. And after observing planets every night for 40 years, he makes a calculation that planet X moves from A point to B point this many times in these years. And because of that, I think this is the formula to calculate the current position of this planet. It will be written like this. And he will also write the current planetary positions. This is what made a Siddhanta text. The author will observe the sky for 20, 30, 40, 50 years. Will write the speed of planets that he have observed using the mathematical formula. Will write the current position of planets. And every astrologer will use that Siddhanta only. This is point worth noticing that at any given point of time, the latest Siddhanta was always followed. Then there was something known as Karan Grantha. Karan Grantha were written by people who were good at astrological mathematics, were good at astrological mathematics. So Karan text is a text which gives planetary positions for 100 years. Calculating it, so they will follow a particular Siddhanta. Suppose someone followed the Siddhanta of Aryabhatta. And he will write a text that according to the calculations of Aryabhatta, these are the planetary positions for 100 years. And he will publish a book. This book will be known as a Karan Grantha, Karan text. And generally, astrologers followed Karan Granthas, Karan texts. Karan is the name of the category of astrological texts. As evident that a current granth, a current text will become obsolete after 100 years because the calculation is given for 100 years only, or 200 years or 300 years. But even in that ancient time, all astrological authors were of the opinion that given any time, given any point, given any consider, the astrologer should observe the planetary position and write planets as per the planetary position. Every classical author is of the same opinion. Every classical author will say that if you have a Siddhanta, no matter how accurate it is, and you also have the access to look at the position of planets at that time when the person is born or when the question is asked, in that scenario, always give preference to the planetary positions that you see yourself rather than giving importance to the Siddhanta that is already available there. So coming to my topic, because Trik Siddhanta is the planetary position right now, as you can see from the naked eyes published from NASA generally, versus Sri Surya Siddhanta, that is the method to calculate planets used on the average and accurate speed given in Surya Siddhanta, which is a text. It is bit obvious, bit natural for us to use Trik Siddhanta, which actually portrays the position of planet, as compared to Surya Siddhanta, which goes by a formula which have become obsolete now. Now, because we have the power to observe planets using modern planetariums, telescopes, etc., Trik Siddhanta is something that needs to be used. So we will select Trik Siddhanta and we'll click OK. Then the next step will be to choose an Ayanamsha. At this place, I use Chandra Hari Ayanamsha. Why? I use Chandra Hari Ayanamsha for three reasons. Reason one, because the calculation of Chandrahari Ayanamsha, the basic star that we choose in the calculation of an Ayanamsha, I will explain this particular part if I go further. So the zodiac in Hindu astrology starts from Aries or Ashwini, like 0 degree of Aries or 0 degree of Ashwini. Now there is no prime star at 0 degree of Ashwini or 0 degree of Aries that can be seen in the sky. There are bright stars in other sections of the sky. So what an Ayanamsha does is it will identify a particular star and will make a particular calculation that this much degree from this particular star is the start of the zodiac. For an example, in the most popular Lahiri Ayanamsha, Lahiri Ayanamsha is not a good name, Chitrapaksha Ayanamsha. Because it is Chitrapaksha, it finds Chitra Nakshatra and takes the calculation that this is the placement of Chitra Nakshatra, and 180 degree from Chitra Nakshatra is the 0 degree Aries or 0 degree Ashwini. Because Chitra falls at the middle point of Virgo and Libra, 180 degrees taken. So all the Ayanamshas take one base star and start calculation from that base star. Right? Because there is no star at 0 degree Aries. Why I use Chandrahari? The first reason is because Chandrahari starts from the Moola Nakshatra. And Moola have a black hole. As you know, as you may know, that stars, although they don't change their position, but they don't change their position very quickly. Over the span of 100 years, etc., the stars also change their position. So it is not very beneficial for a long time to take the position of a star to calculate the start of the zodiac, because eventually in 100 years, 1000 years, 10,000 years, the position of star will also change. Because the Moola Nakshatra starts with the black hole, that's why I use Chandrahari. Because black holes generally don't change their position. Or even if they do, they don't do it as quickly as a star does. Moola Nakshatra is a black hole that is a dead star lying in our Milky Way galaxy. Hence, it is a dependable point from where we can start the calculation. And because it falls in the Sagittarius sign, we take that Moola Nakshatra plus 120 degrees is equal to start of the zodiac. Point one. Point two. Because Chandrahari Ayanamsha, in my experience, have given very good results. As you must be aware of, that I take Charakarkas of Jaimini from minutes, not from degrees. Why? Because in the shloka which determines how to find Charakarkas in Jaimini astrology, the word is Atmakarakah Kaladi Bhiranabhog Sapt Ashtanamava. Because of the use of the word Kaladi, which technically means minutes, I use minutes to calculate Charakarkas. I have written articles on it, I have made many videos on it, you can go and watch them. Right? What I have found, so you know, the minutes to be used to find Atmakarak is explicitly and clearly told by Jaimini. Now, when you start calculating using minutes in any other Ayanamsha, the results are not as accurate as it is in Chandrahari Ayanamsha. Way back then, I cannot recall the year, but back then I took 300 charts. 300 charts I took, and I have a particular formula to find profession using Atmakaraka in D9 that I have taught in my Gemini course, of course. I have a particular formula to do that. And looking at those 300 horoscopes, I made an Excel sheet and calculated the profession for those 300 horoscopes using Lahiri, Aldebaran, Poissonian, every assumption. And what I have found in my personal experience, only Chandrahari Ainamsha was able to give me 97% accurate results. And another Fagan Bradley Ainamsha was able to give me 90% accurate results. And because Chandrahari was the most accurate one, I use Chandrahari Ainamsha, the second reason. And believe me, it was a huge, huge research, right? 300 horoscopes using 12 different Ainamshas. It took me 4 years to complete it. Yeah. This is how much hard work goes. You know, everything have a price. That is the second reason. The third reason is, in my astrological journey, I have talked with many ancient astrologers, many old astrologers, not ancient, many old astrologers. And I have also seen predictions of those astrologers who were considered legends in their area. For an example, Vemuri Ramamurthy Shastri. So I found a horoscope done by Vemuri Ramamurthy. He made the D1 chart. He made the D9 chart. And he have written the birth details also, gave some predictions, and all of them improved. When I made that chart back in the Jagannathura software, I come to find Vemuri Ramamurthy Shastri, using Gemini system, writes a great prediction that because Venus being exalted in D9, because Venus being exalted in the Navamsha of this particular person, this person will be very rich in the second part of his life. This person will be very rich in the second part of his life. Now, when I made that chart in Jehura, I find that Venus is in Aries Navamsha. Now, you cannot change the birth time, because you know that's not an issue. Even if you change the birth time by 3, 4, 5, 6 days, it will remain in Aries Navamsha only. But when I changed the Ainamsha to Chandrahari, Venus was exalted. And you know, the person took consultation from many star worlds back then, many great astrologers back then. And all of them failed. Only two astrologers, one Vemuri and one some other astrologer whose name I'm not taking. Only these two astrologers were correct to predict that the second half of this person's life, he will earn a very good amount of money. Not only Vemuri. I have seen written predictions of many astrologers, many old astrologers, many dead astrologers, many legends from Kolkata, Bihar, Kerala, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka. And surprisingly, in like more than 30, 35 such horoscopes that I saw that the predictions that they are making are more telling with Chandrahari Ainamsha and not with any other Ainamsha, for that matter. Like the one example that I gave you, Venus being exalted in Navamsha, for that particular birth detail is only possible to Chandrahari Ainamsha, and no other Ainamsha does this. Now, if in that chart, if Venus is not exalted, Vemuri will not be able to predict the money in the second part of that person's life. So because of these three reasons, I use Chandrahari Ainamsha. I will give you a quick overview of other Ainamshas present in Jehura as well. So first of all, there is true Lahiri, Chitrapaksha Spika in the middle of Chitra always, versus there is a traditional Lahiri. So Lahiri Ainamsha, after partition, somewhere in 1950s, around 1950s, I don't remember the dates exactly, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru opined that in all over India, there are many panchangas there. And because of these panchangas, because of these ephemeris, one particular festival is celebrated on a separate date in Jammu Kashmir, in a separate date in Bihar, at a separate date in Ahmedabad, at a separate date in South India. So for government holidays, he wanted to have a set calculation to calculate Ainamsha throughout the country. So he made a committee. People participated and presented their Ainamsha. And in that, the Ainamsha proposed by Nirmal Chandra Lahiri, N.C. Lahiri of Kolkata, was chosen to be the one which will be used to celebrate governmental holidays throughout India. The Ainamsha that she proposed, taking the position of Chitra Nakshatra and adding 180 degree to the position of the Chitra Nakshatra, is what came to be known as Chitrapaksha Ainamsha or Lahiri Ainamsha. This is given in Jagannath Hora as traditional Lahiri, the option that you just saw. Then what is true Lahiri? As I told you while explaining about Chandrahari Ainamsha, that despite the fact that stars have a very slow motion, but they still have a motion. So right from the proposal of Lahiri Ainamsha way back in 1950s up to right now, up to 2000s, of course it had been 50 years. So if a nakshatra moves by 1 degree per 100 year, it have moved, you know, 30 minutes by now. Right? So the real position of Spika star in the Chitra Nakshatra, right? The real position of Spika star in the Chitra Nakshatra right now is a bit off from what it was back then in 1950s. So that difference is the difference between true Lahiri Ainamsha and traditional Lahiri Ainamsha. Traditional Lahiri Ainamsha is the formula proposed by Mr. Nirmal Chandra Lahiri of Kolkata way back in 1950s. Whereas true Lahiri Chitrapaksha Ainamsha is the exact position of Spika star in Chitra Nakshatra. Pushyapaksha Ainamsha is proposed and recommended by the author PVN Narasimha Rao, the author of the software himself. Right? And I have a pretty simple advice. If you follow the teachings of PVN Narasimha Rao, use the Ainamsha. Whichever astrologer you follow, use his Ainamsha, of course. Right? That's as simple as that. If you follow my teachings, use Chandrahari Ainamsha. Because of a very simple fact, all the researches that I have done it using Chandrahari Ainamsha only. Now, if you don't apply Chandrahari Ainamsha in your practice, how much do you think that the rules will be applicable? Simple, right? So Pushyapaksha Ainamsha is an Ainamsha proposed by the author of the software, PVR Narasimha Rao himself. Now coming to Ramana Ainamsha, Dr. B.V. Ramana was a legend in astrology. I don't know which Ainamsha he used throughout his life, but later on, I think he proposed Ramana Ainamsha. I'm not pretty aware of, but I think that the children of Dr. B.V. Raman follow Ramana Ainamsha even to this day. Niranjan Babu, Gayatri Devi, etc. Raman Subraj Rama also. I'm sorry if I cannot pronounce your name correctly, Ramanji. Really sorry for that. All right. And I think as a person who loves knowledge, who shares knowledge, right, not being the one who will want to hide it or not want to tell you the complete truth, I'll also tell you what I have heard from people, what I have learned from people, right? And I'm pretty sure that it's gonna be very helpful for you. And I don't want to hold any knowledge with me. I don't know for what reason at all. So coming back to my point. So Ramana and Amsha was proposed by Dr. B.V. Raman in later years. It is used by his children, I think. Like, many people have given me the feedback, being an astrologer who is practicing since last 11 years, I'm in contact with many fellow astrologers, right? I have been told that Nadi astrology, while calculating Nadi astrology, while reading a chart through Nadi astrology, many people told me that Raman Ayanamsha works better than any other Ayanamsha. Point one. Point two, there was an astrologer who used to write back then in, I think, there was an astrologer who used to write back then in 1970s, 80s in the astrological magazine. I forgot the name, I'm extremely sorry. But they also, at that time, that particular astrologer and few other astrologers also opined that while using Vimshottari Dasha to time the events accurately, Raman Ayanamsha works better. So these are two of the opinions, right? Some people way back then in the 70s, 80s opined that Raman Ayanamsha is better to time events using Vimshottari Dasha. Nowadays, the fellow astrologers that I have been in contact with opine that Raman Ayanamsha is better for Nadi astrology. However, for me, as I have told before, for timing events or for anything, I use Chandrahari Ayanamsha only. Right? I will repeat it because I think sometimes my voice is not that great to listen at. Going further, there's a Krishnamurti Ayanamsha that was proposed by Mr. K.S. Krishnamurti. I think Kuttur Subramaniam Krishnamurti was his full name. He's the father of Krishnamurti Paddhati. So the basic idea of Nakshatra Lordship, Ashwini ruled by Ketu, comes from Satya Jatakam, which was later followed in Dhruva Nadi, which was later followed in Bhargava Nadika. Dhruva Nadi was read and researched by Meena 1, Meena 2, and Mr. K.S. Krishnamurti. Meena 1 and Meena 2 only use Ashwini ruled by Ketu up to this extent, as per my little knowledge. Whereas Mr. K.S. Krishnamurti took the research deeper and introduced the uses of Star Lord, Sub Lord, and now the system have been nowadays. Right now the system is very extensive up to Star Lord, Sub Lord, Sub Lord, Sub Lord, etc. KP Khullar, etc. So this is the Krishnamurti Ayanamsha is the Ayanamsha that was proposed by Mr. Kesh Krishnamurti. That's why it is named Krishnamurti Ayanamsha. I think it is very close to B.V. Raman Ayanamsha. I'm not pretty sure of it. But this is what I have heard. I don't practice KP astrology by now. Yeah. This is what Krishnamurti Ayanamsha is. That is an option of using a fixed star based custom Ayanamsha as well. So if you are into astrological research and if you find a star that you think is dependable enough to do a calculations, then you can enter the position of that particular star and can write how many degrees to be added to find the 0 degree and can set your own Ayanamsha as well. This Jagannath Ayanamsha is the Ayanamsha that was proposed by Mr. P.V.R. Narasimha Rao itself. So before introducing Pushyapaksha Ayanamsha, P.V.R. Narasimha Rao ji, along with Sanjay ji, recommended Jagannath Ayanamsha that is also quoted in the software. Rohini Paksha Ayanamsha is the Aldebaran in the middle of Rohini always. That is also a particular Ayanamsha. Right. This is the Ayanamsha given in Sri Suri Siddhanta. There is a Devadat Ayanamsha also. This Devadat Ayanamsha, I will tell you. This Ayanamsha is proposed by some Indian mystic, I think, some Indian mystic or some Indian sage. There is a published book by the name of The Muddle of Ayanamsha as well, where the author have specifically used Devadatta Ayanamsha to show how accurately it works. In my experience, I have two things to share about Devadatta Ayanamsha. The first thing is that someone told me that for people born in India, Devadatta Ayanamsha works better. I never took his idea because I don't think what is the differentiation between someone being born in India or some other country. However, there is a research that there is a research for rectification that if you wanted to correct someone's birth time, you should use Devadatta Ayanamsha and check the Pratyantara Dasha at the time of the birth of the person. The Pratyantara Dasha should connect to the ascendant of D1 chart, Rashi chart, and D9 chart, Navamsha chart to know the accuracy of the birth time. And this can be and this should be achieved using Devadatta Ayanamsha. It's a very big research in astrology by this particular philosophy. This is where the Devadatta Ayanamsha is used, or I have heard of its uses. Other people may be using it, I don't know. I'm not that well aware of things, right? In my personal experience, this particular technique of finding the Pratyantara Dasha at the time of birth, Antara Dasha at the time of birth, and connecting it to the D1 Rashi ascendant and D9 Navamsha ascendant, I do it using Chandrahari and get good results also. Once again, that's why I use Chandrahari. That is what is Devadatta Ayanamsha. Then there's an Usha Shashi Ayanamsha. Usha Shashi were astronomers. This is an Ayanamsha proposed by them. You will also find a Brihat Jatak by Usha Shashi. It's two people. Usha is someone else and Shashi is someone else. Right? By Usha Shashi. Many people opine that the Brihat Jatak of Usha Shashi is just a word by word the same Brihat Jatak as it was published by N. Chidambaram Iyer. However, God knows I have not read either of them. Yukteswar Ayanamsha is an Ayanamsha which someone made by the name of Sri Yukteswar Giri. Yukteswar Giri was the guru of Sri Paramahansa Yogananda. Paramahansa Yogananda of Kriya Yoga. Yukteswar Giri was his guru. Yukteswar Giri in the book Holy Science, the Holy Science, Yukteswar Giri proposes a yuga calculation method. He doesn't propose an Ayanamsha. He proposes a yuga calculation method. So some astrologers, taking a hint from that yuga calculation method that Sri Yukteswar Giri have proposed in the Holy Science, have made this Ayanamsha, which is named as Yukteswar Ayanamsha. But it was not ended. It was not proposed by Swami Yukteswar Giri. It was never proposed by Swami Yukteswar Giri. Someone made it. It is there in the software. Right. Then there is Jain Bhasin Ayanamsha. While translating the text to Sarvartha Chintamani, which is published from Shagar Publications now, Jagannath Bhasin died. So the remaining part of Sarvartha Chintamani was translated by some other author. In the preface of that book, Sarvartha Chintamani, published by Shagar Publications, Sri Jagannath Bhasin, who wrote many books on astrology, proposes his Ayanamsha. That is quoted by the name of Jagannath Bhasin Ayanamsha. Chandrahari Ayanamsha is what I use. I gave you an introduction about it. Phagan Ayanamsha, there Phagan, Cyril Phagan, was the father of sidereal astrology in Western world. Sidereal astrology is what we use in Hindu astrology. Sidereal astrology is stars are fixed. Sidereal astrology is Western astrology. So if tropical astrology is Western astrology. Sidereal astrology is Hindu astrology. Tropical astrology, the sky is made up of seasons. Tropical astrology, Western astrology. Hindu astrology, sidereal astrology, the zodiac is made up of stars, Rashis. Mr. Cyril Phagan, back then in 1800s, lived in West and he practiced Hindu astrology known as sidereal astrology. This is his Ayanamsha, which was later corrected by Bradley. So sometimes you find it as Phagan Bradley Ayanamsha, sometimes you find it as Phagan Ayanamsha. It is very close to Chandrahari, and as I have told earlier, In those cases where I don't find Chandrahari Enamsha in the software, I use Phagan Enamsha only. And for this particular reason, I don't rely on any software other than Jehora, Jagannathpura. Jehora, with love, we call it Jehora. It is Jagannathpura, the name of the software. Just given to us free by Sridhar Narasimha Rao. Right. As I have heard, that to predict mundane events, to do mundane astrology, to predict using the fate of countries, nations, etc., to predict on the horoscope of countries, to predict mundane astrology, to predict earthquakes, famines, etc., Phagan Enamsha gives better result as compared to any Enamsha. However, I don't do mundane astrology, so I have never tested it in mundane astrological perspective. But people opine this. And at 2-3 places wherever I saw, I analyzed an earthquake or something like that, I also opine that Phagan Enamsha, if you want to predict about the future of nations, future of country, future of world, famine, earthquake, etc., using Phagan Enamsha is a better option. Right? But if you ask me, once again, I will go to Chandrahari only. Right. Then there's the Delius Enamsha, Dhujwal Kul Enamsha, Aldebaran at 15 degree Taurus, galaxy center at 0 degree Sagittarius. Just this galaxy center at 0 degree Sagittarius and Chandrahari is almost the same. And however, I go with Chandrahari, as I told. And Hippocras Sasanian is there. And tropical Enamsha, as I told you, right? I just told you the difference between tropical zodiac and the sidereal zodiac. So tropical is the calculation where you use the season based zodiac and don't use any Enamsha. So tropical is no Enamsha. And the star, which is derived by seasons. So see, I will tell you. When sun enters 0 degree Aries, it is the start of a year. That is sidereal zodiac, what we use in Hindu astrology. The day when the day and night becomes equal donates this particular Rashi is tropical astrology, Western astrology. That is the difference. So we will use Chandrahari Enamsha and we will be okay. By this, we have completed two things, Siddhanta, planetary model, Drig versus Sri Sur Siddhanta and Enamsha. Other calculations, I will explain in the next video. Thank you for watching the video. I hope this is useful. If it is useful, you should tell me that it is useful. Because, if it is not useful, then there is no point in continuing with it, right? So, as a creator, as a person who will produce content, I always wait for your feedback. Right? So, do give a feedback by commenting on the video so that I know that the series is actually helping people and I get motivated to do it further. Right? Thank you for watching the video.